Okay, guys, Johnny Five here, and today I'm going to talk to you about the Massive Droner by Catalyst Machine Works. Now, this is the packaging that this thing comes in, and it is awesome. Look at that. You have a nice picture of a Mr. Ron Jeremy up there, and they're covering it cleverly to kind of get away with it. It comes like really nice. You have a link to where to go to get the build tutorial and instructions on how to put this together. This is a little bit of a tricky frame. It's not too terrible though, but it's a little more complex than your standard top bottom plate. Comes with a very nice sturdy Catalyst Machine Works strap. And this particular one is the 3-inch version. I'll put some pictures up that compare this version to the 2.5 inch, which I also have, and kind of give you guys some thoughts. Now, the other special thing about this is I have here the Brother Hobby Avenger motors. These are the new 1507, and this is the 3600 kV version. These motors on these props. Now, these are actually the Gym Fan Flash props. They're the 3052x3 version. This is my recommended 3-inch prop for all 14XX and now 15XX motors. Now, let's talk a little bit about 3-inch for a little bit, guys. 3-inch is a size that I had really all but given up on. I just didn't think there was that much point to flying anything 3-inch for the longest time. Now, I built a fairly light 3-inch a while back using full-size components, and that worked out pretty good. I mean, it was fast. Now, back then, this was over a year ago, there really wasn't any good small 4S batteries available. So I could run like a 600 or a 800 or even a 1000 milliamp 3S, but they were all kind of heavy. And that was 1407 motors that were like 4000 kV, and it was fast, but it just didn't fly right. It flew like a rock falling through the air, and it just wasn't fun in any way. I have my good old Emax motor foam here on the bottom that I use for all my builds. And so I just determined at the time that 3-inch and basically even 4-inch is just kind of worthless. It's just kind of a weird middle ground that doesn't really do much good of anything. It's not really particularly great for racing. It's not fun for freestyling. I basically said 2.5-inch is where it's at. And that was very true for a long time with those, especially with those Emax 1106 motors that are very popular right now. And some people say that they like that on 2.5-inch flash props better than just about anything else out there. I think, though, that this is something special. This, and let's go through the build real quick. This is the Hobbywing Nano Stack 20 amp ESC with F4 flight controller. It's using an AKK VTX XM Plus receiver. And this is the new Foxeer Monster Micro. And man, that camera is awesome. I also have the Eagle Micro, but I think, guys, I actually like this a little bit better. This is also better for nighttime flying. And one thing that you'll notice about the Massive Droner compared to other builds is, one, it's light. Two, it adds a superior amount of camera protection. I don't have any 5-inch racing builds that protect the camera this well. In fact, my Floss 2 regularly smashes cameras. I mean, pretty much like all the time. But look at this. Look how the front profile of this is. This front part right here sticks out so that even an Eagle Micro or a Runcam Split can fit in here with a full camera protection. You don't have to worry about smashing those expensive cameras. Wow. Now, it also has this front brace and the optional rear brace, which I have decided to go ahead and install. That adds you even more protection. This thing is tough. And unlike some of the other frames that use this kind of cage along the side, like the Airblade Eclair, this is a little bit beefier, and it has some nice screws holding these together. And down here, it actually has a nut and a bolt I'm kind of putting on the top plate. I don't think you really need that on both sides. I only have it on one side, but that adds some additional rigidity to the frame that I noticed that the Airblade Eclair just didn't have. Now, it also comes with these forever antenna tube type things, which is really, really nice. A lot of frames don't really do that, and so that's a nice touch. Another thing is that you can notice that when everything is installed in your stack, the stack is pretty well protected as well. And I just love this frame, guys. It's almost escaping me how good this package is. I really wasn't 100% sold on the looks of this thing when it came out. It was just so unorthodox, so different from everything else that's out there, that I just couldn't get on board immediately. But once I actually saw this at an event that was held in Houston, we had an event at the National Aviation Museum where a lot of people came to kind of fly inside of an airplane hangar. It was pretty sweet. And Catalyst Machine Works was there, and they had this with these motors in attendance. And at that point, I just knew that I had to have one. And so now I have several. This is one of them. I think this combo is what makes 3-inch come alive. These motors are the missing link, along with these special gym fan props. So the thing about 3-inch before is it would fly like a brick. It would fly like a brick through the air. It just wasn't fun to fly, and it had like no float, so it really wasn't that close to your 5-inch props. I mean, is this fun to fly around? No, it's not fun at all, and that's exactly how it flew. You would punch up in the air, and it would just go as soon as you let off the throttle, just like a brick. So no, it was not like a ton of fun there, guys, but this combo does have the float and just the right amount, so it's not too floaty. You can push this around the track no problem. And my recommended battery for this is the Tattoo 850 milliamp 4S battery. It's just the right size and weight to go along with this. And I would have to say in a straight line, this might be faster than my 5-inch. It's pretty close. If you're on the fence on what 3-inch to build, this is it. I know some people really like to build like the Japalura, but that's like so heavy. I have 5-inch builds that are lighter than most people's Japaluras. This is the ticket. This comes in at 136 grams. 136 grams. This beat my previous 3-inch lightweight record, which was only 144 grams. And this is lighter, and it has 1507 motors. My old lightweight build had 1407. The power! Oh my gosh, the flight times on this are pretty good. If I'm just cruising around, I can easily get 4 to 5 minutes. Now, if I'm smashing that throttle down, I'll probably lower it to about 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes, but that is no problem. Guys, if you're on the fence, go get one. I just love the design. I love what Catalyst Machine Works is doing. They're down in Houston, Texas. Support, if you're from Texas, definitely support these guys. But I noticed that these are getting more and more popular all around the country. And if I had the opportunity to either get one of those Hawk things, which I also really love, but I have to say this is better. And for any 3-inch out there, if you want this to be your park flyer, it can do it like no other. So I'm going to show some footage flying around the way that I imagine this is the best to do. I'm not going to show you some track flying with this thing. I'm going to show you flying it from my driveway the way that I like to do every day. And I'm going to show you kind of how close I can get to my house comfortably Would I do this with my 5-inch? No, I absolutely wouldn't. But with this thing being so light and so maneuverable, I have no hesitation at flying right around my house. So here we go with the footage. Thanks.
For the block, boy. Take it rough. It's been the same old thing on my block. You either working or you slinging on my block. You had to hustle, cause that's how we was raised on my block. And you stayed on your hop until you made you a knot on my block. To hang out was the thing back then. And even when you left out, you came back in to my block from Holloway, Belfort to Scott. Rerode the flocks, we know the spots to smoke. Drank all the blue dots on your block. You probably bred a fat pad of Tupac. A big pun. Your homeboys from knee high, and even when it was storming outside, that's me, by that's me, dog, on my block. I ain't had to play the big shot. Knew me back when I was stealing beer from Shamrock, and my nickname was Creepy. If Black Joe could see me, he'd be tripping, and I bet he still try to tease me. On my block,
well, everything is everything for Jeezy.
My block,
we probably done it all, homie, believe me.
My block,
we made the impossible look easy for Jeezy. I'll never leave my block, my
haters and the cops. The hot rock, we racing Pollard's chrome dot. On my block, it ain't no different than the next block. You get drunk and pass out, and they pack you to the hot. And when you wake up on the couch, you're going right back at it. On my block, when you dap up, they laugh at it. On my block, it's just another day in the heart of the south side of Houston, Texas, making your mark. On my block, we're queuing all the time, playing dominoes. Keep the swishing sweet down till my mama goes back inside. Then we can fly, passing around a few times. Blah blah,
everything is everything for Jeezy.
Blah blah,
we probably done it all, homie, believe me.
Blah blah,
we made the impossible look easy. Blah blah, I'll never leave my block, my need me.
Blah blah,
everything is everything for Jeezy.
Blah blah,
we probably done it all, homie, believe me.
Blah blah,
we made the impossible look easy for Jeezy. I'll never leave my block, my need me.
Blah blah. Everybody business ain't your business. What's going on in this house? Staying here, comprende? On my block, you had to have that understanding. Cause if you told Miss Maddie, she went and told Gladys. And when Punchy Mama got it, it was all on the wire. And when the word got back, they said, yo, fire. On my block, we got some non-fed shell shock. We never quite got right, now they can help. On my block, it's like the world don't exist. We stay confined to this small little section we're living in. On my block, I wouldn't trade it for the world, cause I love these ghetto boys and girls born and raised on my block.